Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to find the number of even and odd digits in a given number in Java. Let's take an example and understand how to do this. Let's say for example, we have some random number like this, 2 and 6, some 5 and 8. And how to start writing logic for this. First of all, we wanted to find the digit. First we'll extract one digit and then we'll find out whether that digit is even or odd, and then we'll continue the same process for all the digits. But how to extract the digits? First of all, like any number, if it is divided by 10, it leaves the remainder as the rightmost digit in that number. So if I, in this case, if I divide the number by 10, in this case we'll get the rightmost digit here is 8 in our case. So we get 8 as the remainder. So we extracted the rightmost digit in this number now. Now we wanted to find whether this digit is even or odd. How to find whether a number is even or odd? For that, if you divide any number by 2, if it leaves the remainder as 0, then we can say that number is an even number. And if it leaves the remainder as 1, then we can say that number as an odd number. This is the logic we are going to follow now. So we extracted the digit and now we are dividing the digit by 2, and then what we'll do is, if it is 0, if it leaves remainder as 0, then we'll have one variable and then count even, and we'll increment this value each time. And if it is not even, then we can say that the number is odd number. So we'll have two variables which will actually track the count of the even digits and odd digits. And then once we are done with one digit, we should follow the same process for all the digits in the number. But how to actually extract the next digit or any other digit in this number? So for that, what we'll do is, we are already done with last rightmost digit in this. Now we wanted to extract the next digit 5, but how to do this? Again, what we'll do here is, we'll again follow the same process, but this time what we'll do is, we'll divide the number by 10. So when you divide the number by 10, the divisor you get is the number which leaves the rightmost digit in that number. This is what you'll get. So here what we'll get is, if I divide this number by 10, the divisor we get is 2165, leaving the last rightmost digit in that number 8. So this is what we'll get, and this is what we are going to follow. Now let's actually proceed again with the first step. Now we have the original number as 2165. Now we'll go back to the step 1. I'll divide the number again by 10, and this time the remainder is 5. And for the first time, the count was like even count was 1, because 8 was even number. So this will be incremented. So count even is 1 and count odd was 0. And now we have digit 5, and this digit 5 percentile 2. In the sense, you will get the remainder as 1. So it is odd number. We'll increment odd count as 1. Now you have 2165. We'll divide 2165 by 10 again. What is the result we get? We get 216. So again, we'll go back to the first step and divide the number by 10. This time we'll get remainder as 6, as 6 is the rightmost digit now. Now this 6 will, in the second step, we'll find whether it is even or odd. So it is even number, as when you divide it by 2, you'll get the remainder as 0. So increment this count even by 1 value again. So then we'll proceed with the third step. Again, we'll divide the number. What is the number now? 216. So this time 216 divided by 10. So you'll get 21 as the divisor. This is the number now. Now from 21 divided by 10. And what is the remainder we get here? This time we'll get the remainder as 1. Now 1 is an odd number, so we'll increment the odd count by 1. Again, we'll divide the number 21 by 10. This time we'll get the divisor as only 2. We'll again go back to step 1, and 2 divided by 10. What is the remainder? We get 2. as 2 is the even digit. In this step, we'll increment count even by 1. So count even becomes 3 now. Now, in the third step, we again divide 2 by 10. This time, you'll get the divisor as 0. And if you observe, we are done with all the digits. Now we can stop looping this. Then this will be our condition when to stop. With this, we can conclude like we processed like or we completed reading all the digits from the number. And this is the logic. These are the three steps we are going to use in our Java program also. Now let me create a new Java class and apply the same logic in the Java program. I'll name the class as count even or digits. We'll follow the same logic here also. So first of all, what we'll do is to read the number, we'll use scanner class. I'll create a scanner object here to read the number. We'll read the input from user. From the console, we'll take the input. You can import scanner class from Java util class, and then we'll have some variable to hold that value, whatever we read from the console. Next in, so this will hold the value, and you can write a small message to the user to enter the number. Please enter a number. And now we wanted to have two variables, one for counting even digits and other for odd digits. Count even, we'll initialize both to 0, both values to 0. Now we'll start the loop, and our condition is till the number becomes 0. So our condition can be number not equal to 0 or till number is greater than 0. And the first step is we need to divide the number by 10. For that, what we can do is I can declare another variable. I'll name it as digit, as we'll be extracting one digit, and we'll divide the number by 10, and we'll take the remainder into this digit variable. Now we need to write the, we'll go to the second step and write the logic for this. So digit, I'm dividing it by 2, and if it is 0, if it is leaving remainder as 0, then we can say it is an even number. For that, what we can do is we can increment the count even variable by 1. Else we know that it is an odd number. So if it is not even number, it is odd number. So let me increment the value of odd number by 1. Once we are done with this, we'll go to the third step. What's the third step? We wanted to read or extract the next number. For that, what we'll do is we'll divide the number by 10, so that we'll get the result as the number leaving the rightmost digit. You can see here in the same logic. This is the logic we are using. So once we divide it by 10, that's it. It will again go back to the loop, meaning the first step. The first step is this. This is our second step, and this is our third step. This loop continues till our number becomes 0, meaning till all the digits in the number are red. And by end of this loop, we'll get the count of even and count of odd from these variables. So what we can do is we can just try print the values here. Number of even digits. Is count even. And number of odd digits is count odd. We just need to modify this variable count odd. That's all. And as we created the scanner object, we need to close the object. scanner object. Now let us run this program and verify. Run as Java application. Let me give the same number 216 58, and you can see here this is what we got. Number of even digits are 3, 2, 6, 8 are even digits, and 1 and 5 are odd digits. So number of odd digits is 2. Now let us run this same program again, and this time what we'll do is we'll give the input as all the odd numbers. So you can see there are no even digits, all the digits are odd, so we are getting the count as 5. And let me give all the even numbers this time, maybe 6 6 6 6, like this. And you can see here number of even digits is 6, as all the digits in the number are even and there are no odd digits, that's why it is returning number of odd digits as 0. So this is how we can write the logic to count the number of even and odd digits in a given number. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.